Good morning, Arthur. Oh, my head is pounding.
Hosea?
Hey, Arthur.
Come on! If we're gonna make it to this party, we sure as shit better clean up a little.
So we're doing this?
Oh, yeah. Old friend Dutch van der Linde's finally showing his true colors. Social climbing.
Old Signor Bronte, that horrendous snake, has invited us to the ball, Cinderella. So my suggestion is we go and get you a gown.
You son of a bitch!
We are ridiculous.
Utterly.
I ain't never been to a ball in my life.
Nor have I, if I am being honest.
I used to quite often. There can be fine pickings.
Oh, no pickpocketing. We are here to make real contact.
What kind of contact?
Well, I don't know. We'll find what we can. All I know for sure is we are going to a party at the mayor's house, and the guest of honor is the worst crook in town. I am sure that we will find something.
Okay.
Gentlemen, Luca. I'm afraid the mayor does not allow guns at official functions after last year's incident. Luca here will take you to Mr. Bronte. I believe he is expecting you.
Follow me, gentlemen. This way, please, gentlemen. Signor Bronte will be so pleased that you made it.
We are honored to be here.
That's wonderful, wonderful. Come, this way. What a beautiful evening it shall be. Mr. Bronte is a very good friend with the mayor. Good evening, Pierre.
Signor Napoli?
As long as the mayor behaves himself, you know. Mr. Bronte, he has that thing, you know, respect.
Jose, Bill, you join the party. We'll meet you out back after we pay our respects to Signor Bronte.
Come.
We'll meet you out in the balcony when you're done.
Cowboys, you arrived, and you've washed per la prima volta questo mese senza dubbio.
This is quite a party you've invited us to.
Yes, quite something, although I'm not quite sure what.
So, this is Saint Denis High Society.
Yes, apparently so.
And all these people, these are friends of yours, Signor Bronte?
No, not quite. But they certainly are afraid of me. Like that one. See, that wretch is the mayor, Henri Lemieux. He'll do anything for a dollar, and I mean anything.
Politics is a foul business. Yes.
Oh, and that one, too. That is Alberto Fusar. He owns a sugar plantation out on the island, and he comes here to whore and despoil himself. Oh, and that is Hobart Crawley, a Confederate major in the war. And a hero, they say, but that, this is his very young wife. I mean, a young mistress, that's the natural order of things, yes, but a young wife is unseemly.
Oh, the Redskins. I have no sympathy for them, because whoever is stupid enough to get tricked by the Americans, no, they get what they deserve, huh? Yes, and a letter to the mayor. Oh, yeah, that'll save you. And that is Hector Fellows. Mm-hmm. This self-righteous newspaper man. Maybe you will kill him for me one day.
Well, we're not paid killers as such. Not in cold blood, anyway.
I did not know you were so particular that you wouldn't help a friend.
Oh, I'm willing to help in any way I can, within reason.
I'm going to pretend to understand what that means.
I meant no offense, sir.
Well, none taken. None taken! All these vulgar people. They hate me. Non vedo l'ora di guardarti morire.
Well, it has been wonderful conversing with you, but I can tell that you are very busy, and I won't waste any more of your time.
Yes, yes, yes. Go, enjoy yourselves, and mingle with this vulgar scum. It'll make you long for the days when you could shoot each other and screw cows out on the open range.
Those sure were the days. Good day, gentlemen.
Good day to you. But before you go, what exactly are your plans here?
Well, we've not made any... Well, we are going to need some money.
Money, yes, of course. Well, there's money at the trolley station. They keep a lot of cash there in the day. Now, I could not involve myself in such matters. But you... As a guest, yes. As my guest, bah, do it, huh? Okay, good day, gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Okay, ragazzi, adesso il vino buono.
I'll show you to the party, gentlemen, if you'll kindly follow me. Gentlemen, enjoy your evening and welcome once again to Saint Denis. Ciao, ciao.
Gentlemen, let's go ingratiate ourselves. Okay. Go find the mayor if you can and stay out of trouble and steal nothing unless it's information.
Of course.
Jose, you go find us someplace to rob. Bill, go make us some new friends. I'm gonna find out old Cornwall. What's his name?
Glass of champagne?
I mean, not all very well. Camilla McClair, wherever did you get that by that?
If that's French culture for you.
Gentlemen, I hope you're having a fine evening.
Ah, Mr. Mayor, what a
why would you miss me?
What? Well, here was just insulting me regarding the Redskin. I did no such thing. But, Mr. Lemieux, I suggested that all of us, as Americans, had a duty to take care of people living in this land. And that extends to Saint Denis.
It ain't complex, Lemieux. And only an idiot like you, buddy, would try to make it so.
I will not deny idiocy, sir, but perhaps now is not the time.
Typical pansy!
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk. Yeah. What say you and me, cool off?
Me.
Come on, sleep it off.
All right, okay, God damn it.
Sit down.
And count down.
Count to 1,000.
Hello, sir.
Three.
Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Henri Lemieux. I hope you're enjoying my party.
The mayor.
Allegedly.
There's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. Do you know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. The writer?
Well, we seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
My lord, they're fantastic.
Monsieur, please. Mr. Cornwall was quite insistent, I'm afraid. He shouted down the telephone for several minutes.
Mr. Cornwall is a horse's ass, and a bad horse.
I'm very sorry, sir.
It's not your fault. I'm a fool for trusting him. I'll come and sign it in a minute. Let me enjoy the fireworks.
Of course.
Can he say something about Cornwall? Yes. Find out what.
Sure.
Everything's fine. We have the place well secured.
Good.
Mr. Bronte has a habit of wandering about and reading whatever he likes. We're watching him and his men like hawks. Thank you, Mr. Terrapin. Taken care of. The telephone, it keeps ringing.
The mayor said he will sign later.
Marie! Marie! Find that little reprobate Chip and beat him. I will not have standards slip in this house. Have you lost your mind? I said, have you lost your mind? Come here. Come here. Look at me. Look at me. Who do you think you are? This area is not meant for the likes of you. You know this. The standards in this house are slipping. This is a final warning to you, miss. A final warning. I'm sorry, sir, but the party's in the garden. The residence is purely for family. I do hope you understand.
Forgive me. I was unaware.
Now get out of my sight.
Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Top secret. Extremely confidential. Very interesting.
This town is a waste of time.
Maybe not.
Arthur? Gentlemen, I think we're done here.
What did you find out?
There's plenty of money moves through here, of course. I think I found out how we can grab some of the big bank. Real one, I mean. But not yet.
A city bank?
Maybe. And a stuffed one. If we're gonna leave, that could be the one thing we need.
There's also that trolley car station Senor Bronte told us about, and I heard about a high-stakes poker game. Come on. Here comes Lenny. All right. Let's get in. Go home.
Oh, I ain't never felt so awkward in all my life. All them folk are so pleased with themselves. Oh, high society's pigeon shit. If you ask me, it's more like torture.
Well, that's sort of the point, isn't it? Let the people torture themselves.
Here's them papers I took.
Anybody see you take this?
I don't think so.
I might have an idea. Let me think on it. Interesting times.
I guess. So what's next? Dancing lessons? Deportment?
More along the lines of armed robbery. Jose is handling reconnaissance on the bank. He and Abigail are gonna run some distractions, see how the law react.
Good.
Oh, and I spoke to Evelyn Miller. Fine man. Here helping the Indian chief we saw.
Yeah, I met him too, with the mayor.
He's lobbying officials in Saint-Denis on their behalf. Maybe we could help.
Maybe.
Now, I think there's a lot of money on the riverboat. A lot of money. And Trelawney, he's investigating for us. He says to meet him at the tailor's.
Okay.
One big score down here, Arthur, and we disappear. We are almost heading home.
Where is home?
I don't know. Exactly. But I can smell it. I'm gonna go investigate this trolley thing old Bronte was talking about.
Okay. Hello, Mary Beth.
Oh, how are you, Arthur?
Fine. How are you?
Well, I'm well, I think. It's been quite a run we've had, but we're still alive.
So, no regrets?
Regrets for what?
Well, for joining this band of maniacs.
If you're a girl without means in this world, life is very scary. You boys care for me before no one cared for me. Well, life weren't very nice, Arthur. Not after Mama got typhoid, and that was a long time ago.
Sure.
What about you? I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Yep.
And?
Got me thinking how that all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. Or I wouldn't change.
Huh. Well, she was a fool then, Arthur.
Well, she put a lot of good years in on an outlaw. She definitely was a fool.
In these books, life seems so simple, but in reality, I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan! Mr. Morgan, we have a problem. A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
She's been taken by them Foreman brothers she used to run with. Come along!
The Foreman brothers? What are they doing here?
Well, I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
Sure. Do we need more guns?
You and I can handle this, Arthur.
Where are we heading?
I'll tell you on the way. Just get going. Yeah! All right, head for Rhodes. And quick!
She's in Rhodes?
No. She's at a place called Bradley's House, just west of there.
How do you know?
When we first got here, she told me she was worried that our camp was near a safe house that gang she ran with used from time to time.
And you told Dutch?
No. She spoke to me in confidence. I suppose I didn't think it would be a problem.
Now it is.
Oh, yes.
What do they want with her anyway? I think I saw one of the foremans hassling her in Valentine.
Yes. They probably followed us down here. You don't know what happened? She killed one of them, for good reason, but clearly they don't see it that way.
Tilly?
Yes. Young Tilly Jackson isn't as sweet and innocent as you might think. But like I say, she was defending herself. She fled and fell in with us right after that. I just hope we can get to her in time.
It's not too far.
If they touched a single hair on that girl's head, I will eviscerate the sons of bitches.
See? You do care, Miss Grimshaw.
Of course I care. About all of you fools. Okay, I think that's the place up ahead.
I think there's a guard.
I'll deal with him.
Whoa. What you want?
Kind sir. We're lost and in need of some help.
Oh, get out of here!
Oh, I see that kindly face of yours, and I know that for the right inducement, a gentleman such as yourself could be mighty kind.
Now get out of here!
Oh, now you keep saying that. You don't mean nothing by it.
I said...
You said your last word! Well, what are you waiting for?
What the hell? What the hell? You think you're... Ah! What
the hell? What?
It's okay, Miss Tilly. Now, let's get you out of here.
I thought there was...
Yeah, it don't matter what you thought. It's okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. There were five of them, I think.
Well, we killed those fellas there.
There they are.
Come on.
Tilly, grab that gun. Anyone approaches, shoot them.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be just fine. Now catch that bastard. The one in front of the ball. Bring him back alive. I ain't done with them yet.
All right. Get after them. Down the hill, to the water! You picked the wrong girl! And there they are, by the shoreline! Ah! They think they're getting away! They got another thing coming! Ah! Oh! Ah! Well, what are you waiting for? Go! Yeah. Oh, hurry! We're going to lose them!
Come on.
to regret what you did! Back to Tilly so we can all have a nice little chat. I'm gonna head over there now to check she's okay.
With pleasure.
I'll take his horse. He won't be needed.
Look at the floor for a bit.
Do you have the first idea what you're getting into? I'm Anthony Foreman.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Anthony. Is that Foreman with an A? I want the Undertaker to spell it right.
Funny bastard.
Coward.
Oh, shit. Funny bastard. Who are you running with?
She didn't tell you?
She didn't tell me nothing. Oh, this rope is cutting into me.
Don't feel so good when you're the one tied up, does it?
She killed the hell bastard. She killed my goddamn cousin.
Oh, don't worry. You'll be seeing him soon enough.
What are you gonna do with me?
I ain't sure yet. Reckon I'll let Tilly decide what you deserve.
You wasting now. All right, damn it.
Here's your man.
Bring him here. Dump him on the ground here. I want to get a good look at this monster.
So he's still alive then?
Ah.
guess.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman. I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast. She's mine. She ain't yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says, revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want.
Kill him, Arthur!
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave me alone!
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony? Or should I slit your throat and just save us all the bother?
I'll leave you alone. History is done.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat.
Go on. Finish the
bat. All right, you.
Come on. Let's get you home. Yeah.
Now get out of here.
Let's go, girl.
Looking horse you got there. How about we see how fast it is? Hold on a minute. Hear me out. First one to cap this jack?
Yep.
Please, after you.
Hey,
again.
Excuse me.
Ah, there you are, dear boy.
Yes, here I am.
Well, we're going to need to get you smartened up a bit.
What?
Well, you can't play at the tables on a Lanahassee riverboat looking like this.
Can't?
Not if you want to fit in so well no one realizes you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
What are you talking about?
That suit is not fit for the purpose at hand. Come along, dear boy. Come along.
Hello, can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes, my friend here is in need of a new suit. We are playing on the riverboat this evening.
Excellent. Well, you'll find all my inventory in the catalog here.
Make this gentleman look like the Duke he really is. It was the English's fault his grandfather had to emigrate. A bitter and jealous
A people. Very good choice, sir.
You can see the aristocrat in his profile. The heavy brow from all the inbreeding. Come on, let's get you to the barber.
Sure.
Good luck tonight, gentlemen.
Herr Strauss has scoped the whole thing out. It's quite ingenious, actually.
What is?
The action he has planned. Indeed, it's not much of an action at all. You play cards and win. And you're going to bet very big and flamboyantly while you win. And everyone's going to think you're some new money from the oil fields come to lay it on thick and drunk. All the while, Herr Strauss will be signaling you in your line of sight. When you bust the place, they'll take you upstairs to pay you off. And that is when Javier comes in, and you take whatever you want.
You don't think they might see an armed Mexican coming into the safe with me?
Sure, they might, but perhaps not. You will see.
The suspense is killing me.
Oh, don't be so jaded. We both know this is just the kind of innocent fun you thrive on.
Well, after the past couple of months, armed robbery don't seem such an innocent pastime.
No, but we, you, all of us, will be done here soon.
I hope so.
Come on! My good man, could you smarten up my dear hick friend here? This unlikely fellow has made himself a fortune in the oil fields and learned himself not a lick of manners or gentlemanly deportment.
Well, very good, sir.
No, it's not good.
There, very
smart. Not good at all. Come on, let's get to the docks. I've arranged some transportation for us. To the Grand Corrigan, please.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you. From Toad to Prince.
Yeah, this is a bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't winnie up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to burn. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. St. Hamlet. So, who's a mark?
You all right, by the way, driver?
Oh, yes. Don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery, of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't. But the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right guards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
And what money am I playing with?
Don't worry. That has all been arranged. Your chips will be waiting for you. Ah, there she is. Come on.
Okay.
Arthur, leave any weaponry here. They'll search us when we get on. George, we'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir.
Well, hello, pretty. Thank you.
Now remember what I said, Arthur. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Yes, yes, believe me, I heard every word.
Watch Strauss, listen to the dealer, and this should be a very lucky night. There they are.
Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you. Arthur, you remember this pair of boys we met in New York?
Come on, Jim.
Champagne is on dear old Arthur. He's rich as can be and feeling luckier than a turkey that survived Thanksgiving.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, dear boy. Come on, come on, let's head aboard. Drinks on Arthur. Champagne.
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time, but don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Now where can I get a cocktail?
Looks like there's still an open seat, sir.
We have a chair here with your name on it, sir.
Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Evening. Desmond Blythe.
Evening. Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen, let's play.
I hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up, waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all fair?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have.
This is probably a bad idea, but I'll raise you.
Call. Like I said, Mr. Callahan, cowards. All right. We need to get this up to something respectable.
Oh, I'm in. Call.
How did I end up at this table? I'd have more fun throwing my money overboard.
Call, I guess.
Mm. Call. What the hell?
Yes, call.
Okay, sorry, boys. I'm taking it all.
We'll see about that.
To hell with
it. Nah, I'm out. Think I'll wait for this seat to warm up a bit.
I thought as much. Maybe you should have another drink, Mr. Callahan.
Here we go, then.
Hello, my ladies.
Damn it.
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So, what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny, I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting in a hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife. Call.
Sorry to do this to you, but I have no choice. All in.
I'll call. Interesting. They're cowgirls.
Ship. Ship.
I guess my luck held. Is that you done?
Done?
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
Well, I heard there were some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation heads up in New Hanover.
I am 100% all in, Mr. Callahan.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Pair of kings.
Very good, but not good enough.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you!
No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir. Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen.
Please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure. Perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Come with me, sir. You're having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Next, we'll be hiring Negroes.
I know.
I think you're going to like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made, but you can't have everything.
Indeed.
Well, here we are. Just give me 1 second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur.
Thank you.
Guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Idiot, huh?
Shit, let's hope no one heard that. Quick, clear the safe, let's get out of here. Can't believe that asshole had another gun.
View in here is looking pretty good.
How much is there?
Must be a few thousand plus the watch.
Nice. Now let's get out of here, come on. Let's go meet the others.
Sure.
I reckon we've only got a few minutes to get out of here.
If we're lucky.
Was that a gunshot?
It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Won't garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. I'd give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away until we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
At the time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
That's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
Friend is nothing, no good cheat, and I beg you to take back the insinuation.
There he is.
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is. Shoot that man.
Dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch. Apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss, a Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here.
Everybody,